Listen up, furries. I see you out there playing Smash or Pass on Pokemon. I've seen the Vaporeon copypasta. And if I met Lopunny, I would. But just like the YouTube algorithm, y'all are sleeping on sex and Star Trek. And I don't just mean the phenomenal feature-length documentary by Jesse Gender. Jesse, if you're watching this, come guest on my podcast. No, I mean the pure, oozing libido of the Final Frontier. But I'm not gonna do a simple Smash or Pass because sexuality ain't binary. Presenting Gay Fesh's Star Trek Smashability Tier List! Before I get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Some ground rules. This is not a how hot are you ranking. Physical attraction is only one part of the equation. Personality and history are definitely going to play a role. I'm also probably going to be missing some folk you want covered in DS9 because, sorry, there's just too many and I had to whittle it down. I am also going to exclude anyone who was a minor when their character was introduced, so no Wesley, Jake, Adira, Gray, Kes, or any of the cast of Prodigy. Finally, I'm not ranking Andy Billups because we respect and stan our asexual king. So, let me just turn this thing on and... Oops. There we go. Plugged it in. Been a while since I charged this pad. Let's get started with the original series cast. James T. Kirk. B tier. I know, it's James Kirk, legendary for f***ing his way across the galaxy. He's a good-looking dude, don't get me wrong. But sometimes it feels like he doesn't really understand consent. In the immortal words of Sonic the Hedgehog,
that's no good.
Spock. S tier. You're only gonna get one shot every 7 years at this, but he's gonna be so amped up that it's either f*** you or kill you. Leonard Bones McCoy. B tier. I was inclined to say D tier at first, because anyone that folksy and anti-technology probably doesn't know where the clitoris is, but Jadzia did imply that Emeny Dax slept with him and he had the hands of a surgeon. So, I'm gonna trust her judgment on this one. Montgomery Scotty Scott. C tier. I'm sure he knows his way around an engine, if you know what I'm saying. But there was a whole episode dedicated to him getting put on leave because a woman screwed something up in engineering and he decided to blame all women. Nyota Uhura. A tier. One of the greatest ad-libs in the show was when an oiled-up Sulu grabbed her and said, "I'll protect you, fair maiden." And her immediate response was, "Sorry, neither." Which was a wonderful way of saying, "I'm black and I f***." Hikaru Sulu. B tier. Dude's in great shape and knows how to work a pointy thing.
I thought you didn't like George Takei.
Why are you calling me? You're literally right here.
I'm just saying, I thought you'd rate him lower.
Buddy, if I was ranking them based on their actors, I'd have to pull out the F tier for Shatner. Pavel Chekhov, D tier. For the life of me, I never understood what is attractive about that Davy Jones haircut. And the dude is just a real weirdo. Christine Chapel, C tier. Gorgeous, but she only has eyes for Spock, so it's never gonna happen. Janice Rand, B tier. She wasn't on the show long enough to get a proper overall read, but I love that beehive. Mres, D tier. I got nothing against furries, but the only reason I like back scratching is because human nails are dull. Having sex with Acadian means bleeding out.
Also, you're a fish and she's a cat. She'll eat you.
You're a catfish.
BRB, gonna eat myself.
Eric's, B tier. Six limbs might make positions a little more awkward, but it certainly is an intriguing proposition. Jean-Luc Picard, D tier.
D tier? He's the sexiest bald man on the planet and you're going with D tier?
Sorry, but he's Space Dad and I am not pulling a reverse Oedipus. Also, he rocks that bald head, but you're really gonna say sexiest bald man when Avery Brooks is about to come up? Will Riker, S tier. How are you not gonna sleep with the dude who Kirks more than Kirk? Not only does that beard really complete the look, but he's far more often the pursued than the pursuer. Absolutely have sex with this man if you get the chance, but make sure there's room in his schedule. Geordi LaForge, C tier. Sorry, dude, you're way awkward in your romantic overtures. And creating holograms of real people to fall in love with is an ethical quagmire I ain't gonna touch. Natasha Yar. A tier. Make sure she wears that outfit from The Naked Now, and she's definitely someone who will let you know before you cross any boundaries. Worth. C tier. It would be a solid D if not for the inherent kinkiness of Klingon sex. I'm sure I'd have fun in the moment, but the dude has hang-ups. He's gonna pout when you don't marry him right after, and he's definitely the jealous boyfriend type. Also, consider that Worf is opposed to bathing. Beverly Crusher, A tier, especially if she wears those pink pajamas. And if you light the right candles, you might be in for a little supernatural three-way. You don't mind her grandma's sloppy seconds. Deanna Troi, B tier. The emotional connection would be out of this world, but she seems like she's got fairly vanilla tastes. Data, A tier.
He's fully functional and programmed in multiple techniques. How's that not a solid S?
Two things. One, yeah, he's programmed in techniques, but this is the guy who did it. You gonna trust that? And second, I prefer a little emotional connection in my sex, something Data can't provide for most of his character's run. To be clear, he's an A tier, so I definitely would, but it's gonna be a world-class sex doll. Catherine Pulaski, C tier. She's just a gender-swapped McCoy, and she doesn't have a Dax to vouch for her in the sack. Q, S tier. When you have the chance to fuck a god, you take it. Guinan, S tier. She's hundreds of years old. I guarantee you, she knows techniques you ain't even heard of. Benjamin Sisko, S tier. Not only are you sure to have a good time, he's gonna cook for you beforehand. Plus, he's literally the Bajoran Messiah, and he punched out Q. Odo, S tier. Are you kidding? He can literally change himself into anything. Want a new hole? Need a hole plugged in a new and unique way? He's your guy. Wanna smash all those Pokemon you swiped right on? He can be them. Jadzia Dax. S tier. If there were a tier higher than this, she'd be there, and it would be named after her. Folks, Dax doesn't just f***. Dax has 9 lifetimes of getting her f***ed on. Curzon Dax canonically died from Jamaharon, and if my man can take the Horgon all the way to the hilt, he automatically ascends to sexual Stovacor. Jadzia can throw with the best of them, and she ain't picky with looks. She f***ed a dude with a transparent skull. I tried that once, and let me tell you, paper bags disintegrate pretty quickly in the ocean. Ezri Dax, C tier. I know, I just talked a big game about Dax, but Ezri brings a lot of baggage and integrates very differently with her symbiont. She's cute and all, but I get the feeling she just starfished the whole time. Julian Bashir, B tier. Dude, you're cute, but you can be annoying and actually a little creepy sometimes. Plus, you are clearly oblivious to Garak's advances.
You're forgetting that he's genetically engineered with a super brain. He probably could calculate a way to get you off in like 2 seconds.
I'm a little demi. There's more to sex than just technique. Miles O'Brien, A tier. A man-child like him landing Keiko means he's gotta be laying some serious pipe.
I thought there was more to sex than just technique.
Yeah, being the descendant of a Union man is a big plus too. Quark, D tier. Misogynistic troll and a capitalist to boot. Sure, he can be charming, but most of the time he chooses not to. And you know he doesn't care if you came. Kira Nerys, B tier. She should be A, but her taste in milquetoast men before Odo suggests she's rather vanilla under the sheets. Now, if we were ranking the Mirror Universe counterparts, she would definitely be S tier. But so would all Mirror Universe counterparts. That universe horny. Wayoon, A tier. You'll probably get stabbed in the back when you're done, but Vorta are extremely diplomatic and eager to please, if you know what I'm talking about. Win Adami, D tier. Heinous bitch and space pope to boot? So you know she's got all that religious baggage that will make her incapable of enjoying it. Plus, she f***s Dukat, and I will not be metamorphosed with Space Hitler. Female Changeling, D tier. Sure, you've got all the selling points of being a changeling, but unlike Odo, she's literally the head of a genocidal regime. You can do better. Cassidy Yates, A tier. She's a strong and independent freighter captain, and for those with a breeder kink, Even 24th century contraceptives don't always do the job. Elam Garrick. S tier. Tinker, tailor, soldier, spy, Garrick will plainly and simply give it to you from behind, and then berate you for turning your back to him. If you listen closely, you can hear the sound of a thousand bottoms key smashing. Ducat, D tier. Aforementioned space Hitler. I don't sleep with fascists. Damar, C tier. Works to redeem himself in the end, so he gets bumped up, but only after he was pushed out politically. So he's like a space Rudolf Hess. Rom, S tier. I don't care what he looks like. Whatever Lita sees in him, you should too. The dude quotes Karl Marx, unionizes Quark's bar, and becomes the Ferengi Bernie Sanders at the end of the series. This Umox is praxis. Martok, B tier. Martok may be the goat Klingon, and Klingons are kinky to boot, but like his eye, he has only one love, and you ain't her. Lita, A tier. If she were actually Chase Masterson, it would be S tier for sure, but Lita is a little dumb. Catherine Janeway, B tier. I'm a sucker for that voice, but her holodeck browsing history shows she's into some old-timey shit. Apprentice to Leonardo da Vinci, governess of a lord's manor, girlfriend of a 19th century Irish bartender? He cute though. Chakotay, D tier. Dude, if you were any more boring, you'd be a block of wood. Aguchi Moyo yourself up some bitches. You're far from the bone of this person. B'Elanna Torres, S tier. A formative crush of mine growing up in the 90s, and according to Seven of Nine's lack of understanding of boundaries, she is a very noisy f***. Tom Paris, A tier. Good looking, sarcastic, bad boy streak to him. Plus, he hit it and quit it when he was a transwarp salamander, something Chakotay couldn't accomplish in 7 years. Neelix, D tier. He's jealous, possessive, and that whole mess with dating a 2-year-old is an instant turnoff.
Kessa's species only lives 9 years. That's not a fair comparison.
Assuming we're working with, like, dog years here, that still only makes her a teenager. And Okampan females don't hit sexual maturity until 4 or 5. Tuvok, C tier. Tuvok's dispassionate disposition isn't even overcome during Ponfar. 7 of 9. B tier. Gorgeous, but emotionally distant. She may have assimilated a lot of awesome techniques, but she has a good chance of breaking you, and I like my limbs intact. Plus, those implants probably chafe. Look at her hand. You want that on your groin? What I'm saying is, she's hot enough to override these concerns to an extent, but not enough to hit the higher echelons. Harry Kim, C tier. Did he take Geordi's How to Get a Date class at the Academy? The Doctor, B tier. He's the wrong kind of nerd for me, but I can imagine some creative uses of his holomatrix. Jonathan Archer, B tier. I don't really think of Archer as a sexual being. Sure, he has sex, but it never really registers to me. But he's got a dog, so that's a big plus.
Wow, gonna talk about loving dogs right in front of me?
Hello, bi person here. I'm allowed to like two things. Phlox, S tier. The entire Denobulan race is S tier. They're all poly and have zero sexual repression. You know you're in for a good time. Plus, have you seen how long their tongues are? T'Pol, D tier. The cat suit is for the studio and doesn't reflect her personality. While she did warm up to her crew eventually, T'Pol is cold, detached, and condescending for most of her run. I get the feeling she would be judging you for sexual etiquette you weren't even aware of. Malcolm Reed, C tier. I prefer a man who knows what he likes, and Malcolm doesn't even know that he likes guys. It's the 22nd century, dude. You're living in a fully automated luxury gay space communism and you don't know about the gay part? Travis Mayweather, C tier. I know, it's not your fault, bro. It's on the writers that you were never given a character. If you'd had a couple more focal episodes, I might bump you up, you're cute. Hoshi Sato, A tier. Hoshi started as the most timid and unspaceworthy officer on the NX-01, but is canonically the first human to partake in Jamaharon. And to steal a line from Kirk, she has a talented tongue. Charles Tripp Tucker III, C tier. His sense of propriety would get in the way of having a solid good time, and I don't really go for that folksy charm. Michael Burnham, C tier, entirely for her benefit. She tends to have a habit of making bad decisions that lead to disastrous consequences. See, starting the Klingon War, dating a sleeper agent, serving under a Mirror Universe officer, whitewashing the crimes of a genocidal maniac. I don't want our hookup to lead to, like, the Tellarites seceding from the Federation. Saru, C tier. Sometimes someone can be too tall. I'm 6'2", and I'm a big enough guy to admit that seeing people significantly taller than me is intimidating. Plus, I don't want to get in the way of his thing with the Vulcan president. Paul Stamets, B tier. Before the mycelial network mellowed him out, he'd be a hard D, but he softened up enough in his demeanor that now he can instead take the hard D. Sylvia Tilly, A tier. I'm a sucker for redheads, and the way she babbles enthusiastically and nervously reminds me an awful lot of Season 1 Data, who was easily good enough for Tasha. Hugh Culber, A tier. Sometimes I want someone who will listen. Ash Tyler, D tier. I'm sorry, but I can't trust that his programming won't activate mid-coitus and snap my neck. Joanne Owoshakun, S tier. She's buff, she's badass, she runs ops, she's hot, she was raised by Luddites and was like, F that, I'm going to space. And of course, she's one half of my favorite ship. Kayla Detmer, S tier. The other half of my favorite ship. A kick-ass pilot with a cyborg undercut who only Owo can truly understand. The writers f***ing know, by the way, and they're toying with us. Nan, A tier. The Barzans are known for dedication to booty above all.
That's duty above all.
Duty to that booty. Jet Reno, D tier. I love her to pieces, but I'm just not attracted to her in that way. Remember, this is not a ranking of favorite characters. I put Picard in D tier for God's sake. Gabriel Lorca, S tier, automatically by virtue of being from the Mirror Universe. I know I said no space fascists, but I meant no prime space fascists. Christopher Pike, S tier. What a beautiful, beautiful man, and my favorite captain in all of Star Trek. Cleveland Book Booker, S tier. Incredibly sexy accent, incredibly hot, incredibly only the second cat owner in Star Trek? Philippa Georgiou, S tier. Same reasons as Lorca. Agnes Girardi, D tier. She's murdered half the people we know she slept with. I'm not flipping that coin. Soji Asha, S tier. She's created from harvested neurons of Data, is flesh and blood, and has a full range of human emotion. That Andressi got Narek questioning his loyalty to Romulus. Elnor, C tier. The boy's cute, but while you were hooking up in college, he studied the blade. Also, he was raised by nuns, so that's a toss-up. Rothy Musiker, A tier. Get her sober, and it's S tier. If she brings me to her trailer at Kirk's Rock, it's S plus. Cristobal Rios, B tier. Although, if his holograms come as a package deal, I could be convinced to bump it up to an A. Call that the sextuple multiplier. Beckett Mariner, C tier. Call me crazy, but she comes across as a total pillow princess. Brad Boimler, B tier. Brad's a good boy. You'll have to make the first move, but he's so eager to please that you could probably let him do all the work. Devana Tendi, S tier. Tendi doesn't do anything without the maximum amount of enthusiasm. Plus, her pheromones are a natural aphrodisiac. So, Sam Rutherford, A tier. I feel like you could just walk up to him and be like, hey, do you want to go have sex? And he'd be like, okie dokie. And 20 different sex programs would activate in his cyber brain. Carol Freeman, C tier. Self-centeredness seems to run in the family. I feel like she wouldn't even sleep with you unless it could benefit her career. Jack Ransom, C tier. The sexy thing about Riker is he didn't really try, he just did. Ransom is a tryhard. Shax, S tier. I have only three words. It's naked time! Tiana, D tier. Like with Imres, I am not looking to bleed out when I'm scratched. And unlike Imres, that's likely to happen even if we aren't f***ing. She's early. So, what do you think? Where do you disagree? Any characters you think I missed? Leave a comment down below.
I'm gonna write about how you're wrong about all the Cardassians.
Wow, even Garrick?
Especially Garrick.
Be sure to like, subscribe, ring the bell, and share the video with your friends. Subscribe to my Patreon to get shouted out in future videos. Check out my Bandcamp for banging tunes, including all the tracks you heard in this video. Follow me on Twitter at GayestFesh, and don't forget to check out my podcast, The Rest of Both Worlds, where I go through Star Trek The Next Generation with a friend who's never seen it. Thanks to my patrons Pifflecakes and Renee Vorbeck, your support is greatly appreciated. See you all in the next video.